In this question, what is given? Water flows over a rectangular notch of 1 meter wide with a head of 15 centimeter. He has given for a width, I'll write it as L, of 1 meter wide and head of 15 centimeter, that is capital H is 15 centimeter, which is nothing but 0.15 meter here. And then he has given 15 centimeter afterwards passes through a triangular notch of 90 degree. First, what he has told initially, if I write a notch here like this, this is the channel here, what I have written, a rectangular channel here. At this point he has a rectangular notch. In this point he has a rectangular notch, and after that at another point he has a triangular notch. So I'll write here, after that he has a triangular notch of 90 degree, that means theta is 90 degree here. And he has given, take CD for a rectangular notch and V notch as 0.62 and 0.59. He has given CD for a rectangular. CDR means it is a rectangular notch. It is 0.62, and CD for a V notch, I'll write it as V, that is 0.59. This is the CD value what he has given. Right, and what is asked? Find head over a triangular notch. Right, here this head is for rectangular notch itself. He has given 1 meter wide with a head of 15 centimeter. That is head for a rectangular notch. He has asked find the head for a triangular notch or a V notch here. First, I shall write a discharge through a rectangular notch. Q is what? QR is the discharge through a rectangular notch, that is 2/3 CD of a rectangular notch into L into root 2G H raised to 3/2. When I substitute the values of this, that is 2/3 CD of a rectangular notch is 0.62 into 0.62 into 1 into root of 2 into 9.81 into H is what? H is 0.15 here, 0.15 raised to 3/2. So I'll get discharge QR is 0.1063 meter cube per second. This is the discharge over a rectangular notch. That means whatever the fluid which is flowing over a rectangular notch, the same amount of fluid should flow over a triangular notch here. Right? Because as the discharge for a triangular notch is same as for the discharge on the rectangular notch itself. Right. Now, so I'll write QR is equals to QV. It's a rectangular notch here. That means I'll write this as 0.1063, which is equals to, I'll write a formula to find out a discharge over a V notch or a triangular notch, that is 8/15 CD of V notch into root 2G into tan theta by 2 into H raised to 5/2. Now when I substitute the values here, 0.1063 is equals to 8/15. CD of V notch is 0.59 into root of 2 into 9.81 into tan theta, here he has given as 90 degree, tan 90 by 2 into h is again what we are supposed to find out here, 5 by 2. Only unknown in this is the h. To find out h, find out the value of h here, h is equals to, you'll get in terms of the value of h is 0.3572 meter. 0.3572 meter is the value of h. Right. Now, some tips to do the numerical on this. Sometimes what happens, instead of a triangular notch or a rectangular notch, we use a trapezoidal notch or a stepped notch. Then how to find out the discharge over a trapezoidal notch? This is a discharge over a trapezoidal notch. So I'll divide this trapezoidal notch into two halves, that is two categories here. One, this is a rectangular notch here. That means A, B, C, D is a rectangular notch, and here I'll divide like this, that is A, D, F, and here I'll divide it like this, that is C, B, E. Right. So what I've done, I've taken a trapezoidal notch into rectangular notch and two half of a triangular notch. So I'll combine this. First, I'll write it here. This is A, B, C, D is a triangular notch, and combining both, I'll write it as C, F, E. C, F, E is a triangular notch. So this total angle is what? It is theta here, and this becomes theta by 2. This becomes theta by 2 here. Similarly here, theta by 2 and theta by 2 here. Right. So what I've done, I have converted a trapezoidal notch into a rectangular notch and a triangular notch here. So what will be the discharge? Q is the summation of both, that is QR plus QT. QR plus QT here. QR is what? 2 by 3 CD. I'll write CD for a rectangular notch. CDR into L into root 2G H raised to 3 by 2 plus 8 by 15 into CD into tan theta by 2 into root 2G H raised to 5 by 2. This is how we find out a discharge for a trapezoidal notch. If in the numericals, if they ask to find out a discharge through a trapezoidal notch, you need to add both, that is one triangular notch and one rectangular notch, to find out a discharge through trapezoidal notch. Similarly, if we have a stepped notch like this, we have three steps here. I have taken this as section 1 or area 1, area 2 and area 3 here. That is for length L1 and height is H1 from above free surface here. L2 is the length of the second section and height H2 from the free surface, and L3 is the length of a stepped notch for third section, that is height H3 from a free surface here. Now this discharge is Q is equals to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 here. Discharge is this one, but I can write this one as Q is equals to, section 1 is this one. So I'll write 2 by 3 CD into L1 into root 2G into, here H1 is only, H1 is this one, H is this one, but this one I don't have the direct value, so I need to subtract by these two here. So I'll write H1 raised to 3 by 2 minus H2 raised to 3 by 2 plus discharge for Q2 is 2 by 3 CD into L2 root 2G. Here again, this height is this one, from here to here. From here to here, that means H2 minus H3, that is H2 raised to 3 by 2 minus H3 raised to 3 by 2. Okay? Plus 2 by 3 for the third section, 2 by 3 CD into L3 into root 2G. Here H3 is only this one, that is H3 raised to 3 by 2. We don't have any other thing. So this becomes a discharge over a trapezoidal notch for having 3 steps. Whatever we measure from the surface itself. Height is measured from the surface of the water level, right? So this height should be known here. So I'll take H1 minus H1 raised to 3 by 2 minus H2 raised to 3 by 2, or else directly you can do if you have the values there, right? Thank you.